bone.
It is indeed.
The Glenn Miller, how old was he?
He was 12 years old.
12 years old.
Right, this trombone is a Frank Holton Revelation Wonder is the model.
Touch the mouthpiece. That's fantastic. It's so light.
Yeah. Yes, and it's a relatively small instrument by today's standards, certainly, but it was just about the right size for a 12-year-old back in 1917. And he earned money to purchase that horn from his shopkeeper that he was working for, and he was also the band leader at that time back in this little town in Grant City, Missouri. Mm-hmm. His name was John Mossbarger. And John made sure that Glenn paid for this trombone so he would appreciate it. And over the years, Glenn always said that Mossbarger was really his best teacher as far as trombone was concerned. And he paid for that horn by milking cows and sweeping out the tailor shop that John Mossbarger had.
That's marvelous.
Absolutely marvelous.
Really nice. Thank you for letting me hold it.
Oh, yes.
You're on sacred territory, John.
That's great. Oh, great.
There's something
did
else
you
here
that
we
that
thought you might be interested in.
He missed people, I guess, that he knew in college.
And that's his handwriting.
That's his handwriting.
Well, I guess he had people sign, because it was all different.
Different handwriting,
yeah, so he must have had people sign this. But what you will see is how meticulous he was.
Wasn't he?
He kept pictures of the bands, the early bands that he played with in college, and then he cut out all the newspaper clippings. And then he made comments about everybody. And these were various people in this first band here in college.
Ralph, I'm... Say, I'm Boyd.
Well, I'm going to have this to go, really just like Bill.
Yeah, oh, I was supposed to visit today.
This way we can handle these pages without touching the pages,
them.
And the stuff, the glue will come loose at some point. We want the things to stay in the page at least that they
yes.
came from. And we've had others that have been playing in bands, doing performances all the time, every night,
yeah.
practicing, writing, and he still was so meticulous about keeping something like this. Because they probably went and played. Or things that just interested him. Found
mm-hmm.
and give it to us, so we're really thrilled.
This is so meticulous, I cannot believe that a youngster
college
or a college
boy.
Kid.
That was interesting. Is that a part of the Kingdom family that are still in Boulder?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Luke Kingdom and,
right.
Okay. Sally.
That of the places they perform.
Good. You almost feel like you know him.
I'm getting to know him very well. Yes. And every time I see Alan's program, which I've seen many, many times, I still am moved.
Yeah.
I mean, every time. Because every time Alan does it, it's like the first time for him.
Yeah.
The way he presents it.
Yeah.
It's just
he
wonderful.
Has such a manner
yeah.
of presentation that.
I can take you. You went and done.